Ash Wednesday. It's the very beginning of our Lenten journeys that will take us right through and up to Easter Sunday. And it's also Valentine's Day, so happy Valentine's Day. Let us meet in the spirit of prayer. O Holy God, we gather here to remember and to offer our lives as a living sacrifice and love to you for all that you have given us. During our Lenten journey, may we remember all the incredible love that poured out from Jesus throughout all of his life, through all of his ministry, and even to his death on the cross for our sake. Tonight, we remember especially the love that poured out from Jesus as we begin our Lenten journeys. Be with us now. We ask this in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Now, if you would, please open up your hymnals, the red books in the pew, and join us in singing 40 Days and 40 Nights, and we will do verses 1, 2, and 5. This is my commandment, love one another.
If you heed my commands, you will dwell in my love, as I have heeded the Father's commands and dwell in his love. This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you.
This is my commandment, love one another. This is my commandment, love one another. Now please join in our unison prayer. God, on this Ash Wednesday, we come before you acknowledging your greatness, exalting your supreme power, declaring that you are the God of our salvation. We come confessing the multitude of our transgressions, known and unknown. God, we know that we have not helped the needy when there has been need. We have been greedy even in the land of plenty. Lord, we know that we've abused our brother, misused our sister, forgot about our parents, played our friends. We're guilty and we need your grace. And so we bow before you, kneel before you, because we need you to respond to our human need. Wash us, because we're dirty from our indiscretions. Teach us, so that we may live and declare your truth. Purge us, so that the shame of today will not be the guilt of tomorrow. Create in us newness of life, happiness of heart. Restore to us the full blessings of heaven. Deliver us from the penalty we deserve. And we will rise up, we will stand up, we will get up and live up to the expectations of your calling on our lives. These things we pray in the most powerful and mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Now you may be seated.
Teach me wisdom in my secret heart.
Our gospel lesson this evening is from the gospel according to Matthew, chapter 6, verses 1 through 6 and 16 through 21. Beware of practicing your righteousness before others in order to be seen by them, for then you have no reward from your Father in heaven. So, whenever you give alms, do not sound a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, so they may be praised by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your alms may be done in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners, so that they may be seen by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But whenever you pray, go into your room and shut the door, and pray to your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you fast, do not look somber like the hypocrites, for they mark their faces to show others that they are fasting. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, put oil on your head and wash your face, so that your fasting may be seen not by others, but by your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust consume, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consumes, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. This is the gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us be in a spirit of prayer. Dear God, as always, I pray that the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts are acceptable in your sight, O God, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. It's me, O Lord. It's me. Standing in the need of prayer. You all know that song, right? It's a song that reminds me that none of us are free from the need of prayer. Sometimes we may look at our lives and we feel that they're absolutely perfect. There couldn't be anything that could be better. And we should be rejoicing and praising God. But there are others of us who have struggles of all kinds. And we need to turn to God as well and say, thank you for what I have, but pray to be able to still see through the dimness and the darkness in our lives. Help us to still see that you are the great and powerful and loving God. In our Psalter lesson tonight, we are reminded that in our hearts and minds, when we begin to understand what is true and what is truth that comes from God, we begin to see things differently. Then we can desire things that are part of God's realm, that raises our hearts, our thoughts, and our desires to an everlasting, steadfast relationship with God. We desire truth from our earliest days of learning. We want to be able to understand, and as we begin to understand things in life, we also begin to learn about our faith. And we have a desire for understanding with that as well. And our parents and our Sunday school teachers and our godparents help us along our way. And as we grow in faith, we learn how to comprehend and live lives that praise God as well. Now, some of us, we do that by loving God with all our heart and by loving others. And that is what God calls us to do. That's the great commandment of all. In our Psalter lesson, the psalmist writes as a part of prayer, for God to teach us wisdom, to purge our sins and wash us clean. We want to experience joy and gladness. We ask God to create in us a clean heart so that we may sing your praises. For we want to experience the joys of salvation, and we long to feel the presence of the Holy Spirit. In our gospel lesson, we are reminded to serve and to live for the glory of God. If we go back to our gospel lesson, it says, beware of practicing your righteousness before others in order to be seen by them. So whenever you give alms, don't sound the trumpet as the hypocrites do, but give them anonymously. Don't brag about all the great things that you do for God. Don't brag about how much money you give. Don't pray for the purpose of showing off that you know how to pray. Pray because in your heart you need to be connected with God in a closer manner. And how much closer can we be with God than to enter into a time of prayer? Now, when we enter into a time of prayer together in God's house, God recognizes it, and God loves us for doing it. Because we're not standing on the street corner saying, pray with me, brothers and sisters, for our own glory. We are praying together for the well-being of God's world in God's house. But we also need to spend time privately in prayer with our God. In the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, whenever we feel that we need to have that connection with God. And it's okay to encourage others in our lives to donate to the ministries of God. And it's okay to encourage others to pray for the glory of God. And it's okay to live lives of righteousness for God's name's sake, as long as we're not doing it for our name's sake. We need help so that we may inspire others. But do these things in secret as well as in private conversation with brothers and sisters in the world. And I promise that our rewards will be great. Now, I don't know how many of you follow Facebook, but I received a post that Pope Francis had shared this last week about fasting. And it's somewhat different from the fasting rituals that we read in the Bible. Here are Pope Francis's words. Fast from hurting words and say kind words. Fast from sadness and be filled with gratitude. Fast from anger and be filled with patience. Fast from pessimism and be filled with hope. Fast from worries and have trust in God. Fast from complaints and contemplate simplicity. Fast from pressures and be prayerful. Fast from bitterness and fill your heart with joy. Fast from selfishness and be compassionate to others. Fast from grudges and be reconciled. Fast from words and be silent so that you can listen. I believe that Pope Francis was sent by God to this world, for he has a spirit of love and gratitude and compassion that the world so desperately needs to see and be witnesses of. I give thanks, even though I am not a Roman Catholic, I give thanks to Pope Francis for being so kind and so loving in the name of Jesus Christ and God, our Almighty Father. The power of the Holy Spirit that flows around our world. And all we have to do is open our eyes, open our ears, and open our hearts to feel that Holy Spirit. And I promise you, we will never be the same. Last night I was home, which is a very rare thing. I always seem to have something going on. It's meetings or rehearsals or performances or events. And I was sitting in my den, rifling through 200 channels of nothingness. And I decided to go to Netflix. And I was scrolling through hundreds of movies and shows. And then I saw this show called Jesus, a Revolution. And I decided to watch the preview. And it very quickly grabbed me. And just in the preview, tears started rolling down my cheek. And I urge you all, if you do one separate thing from your life this Lent, take a couple of hours and watch that movie, because it speaks to us on so many levels. The movie was about the hippie movement back in the 60s, and about how churches, or at least this one particular church, seemed lifeless. People were there, not a lot of people, but people were there, but it seemed lifeless. And you could tell in the pastor's face that he was concerned and worried. And at one point of the movie, he questioned his own faith and his Christian leadership. And it was after he had welcomed a totally different kind of people into God's church, not his church, not the parishioners that went there's church, but God's church. Because Jesus calls all to be his people. And the miraculous things that occurred touched me deeply. And not all of it was joyful, and not all of it was easy. Some of it was difficult to watch, but so is life. Life is difficult to be a part of sometimes, but our rewards, if we truly give our lives and our hearts to Jesus. Miraculous things can happen. I appreciate you all for being here tonight. I appreciate you wanting to be in this space, in God's house, to begin your Lenten journeys with each other. Maybe we are called to be leaders together. The Jesus movement started over 2,000 years ago, but actually it began generations before that, because God told the world that the Messiah would come, and prophets continued through the Old Testament to tell the world that the Messiah would come. Folks, we've already received the gift. We've already received the prize because we know that Jesus came. And I believe that Jesus walks with each and every one of us every day. So let us be siblings as we walk out into the world. Let us be those that will show the love of God in any way we possibly can to everybody whose paths we cross. God, create in all of us a clean heart so that we may serve you and glorify you in every step and every moment of our lives, and forgive us when we step sideways, but welcome us when we come back. You may remain in your seats as we sing hymn number 515, Give Me a Clean Heart.
Thank you.
together as your people. No matter what our faith tradition is, we all believe in your almighty power. We believe in your love. We trust in your wisdom. And we seek to honor and worship you. And one of the ways we do that, Lord, is by gathering together in prayer. Today, dear Lord, there are so many needs in our world. For two families, right here in Rhode Island, that lost everything in house fires. Fortunately, both of them, everybody in the family, including pets, were able to get out safely. But they've lost everything. But they still have each other, Lord. And they still have you. And may your people gather around them in love and support in any way that we can. We pray for Judy's exam tomorrow. We pray for the people affected by the Kansas City shooting after the Super Bowl parade. These unnecessary acts of violence continue to rock our world. And sometimes it seems difficult to be able to keep focused on you, God. But we know that you are there. And we know that you don't cause these things to happen. They happen because it's part of human lives. It's part of earthly living. And your realm reaches us far above all of our trials and our cares in this world. But we still seek to be your love and your light. We pray for Cindy's back as she continues to struggle with many issues. We pray for dear sister Michelle. And we pray for our dear friend, Diane, that she gets good test results this week. We pray for her spirit to give thanks blessing that she is to so many. We pray for the Dee Medeiros family. We pray for all of the homeless in the world, especially for Scott Silva. We pray for Lori, who has so many health struggles, but through it all, she keeps this vision of hope and positive attitude. It must be you, Lord, that speaks through her, that can give others hope when things seem so difficult and overwhelming. And we pray for so many people in Mike and Joanne's family that have struggles financially, health-wise, and for dear Zachary. We offer prayers for Elizabeth as she's working and trying to quit smoking. And we know, like any addiction, it's so difficult. Give her strength and give her the right mixture to be able to accomplish this very difficult task. We offer prayers for Adrian Marchetti, who is the director of Tuckett Soup Kitchen, who was not at lunch or dinner tonight, and no one has heard why. We pray that she is okay, and we give thanks for her love and her service to you by being there for so many others. Pray for my sister-in-law, Jolynn, who suffers from MS and is in the final stages. We pray for my partner, Glenn, who has been struggling with illnesses on and off since November, but also for his sadness over his sister, Jolynn. Dear God, we ask you to give all of us strength and wisdom and compassionate hearts so that we may help others in our world. We love you, God, and we thank you for the gift of Jesus in our world. We offer all these prayers and those that are not mentioned as we join together in saying the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
blessing but cannot come forward, just let me know and I will be happy to come to you.
Thank you.
go, for we are God's children. I pray that we are always fed and nourished and grow closer to the Holy One. May we all grow in love and love by serving. May we be joyful and free. May your Spirit's power fill us. Hear the tender comfort that you instill. Go, my children, fed and nourished, joyful.